Baby, you need to get well for me. You know, hubby always likes seeing you lively and active.
Yeah, baby, I'll be fine, okay? You don't need to worry much. Besides, the doctor said my health condition is responding to treatment. Thank you so much for all your care these days. I'm also sorry for all the stress I've been putting you through.
Don't mention, sweetie. Point of correction, it is not a stress, rather a pleasure to me.
Oh, you're such a sweetheart.
Thanks, my love. So, what would you like for breakfast?
Maybe jollof rice and fried plantain. Can you prepare that, baby?
Consider it done, ma. I would go in now to start making that for my angel.
Thanks, honey.
Madam, good afternoon, all.
Yeah, good afternoon. How may I help you?
My guy asked me to come and see him.
Okay, just wait. Let me call him out. Sweetheart! Sweetheart!
Yes, I'm coming. Oh, MD, you are here.
Boss, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ND. Baby, please help me attend to him. I need to go check what's on the fire before it gets burnt.
It's all right, dear. I will. You can continue with what you're doing.
Ogaweto, you mean you were cooking that very day while your wife was in the parlor watching Z-World? Hey, Oga, are you sure that woman has not used charm for you? Oga, I want you to reason clearly. The woman you called wife is already turning you into her errand boy. Watch out. Very soon, she will start asking you to wash her clothes. Oga, now listen. I want to give you an advice because I know that you are a gentleman. But don't ever repeat that nonsense again, or else you will turn yourself into a houseboy in your own house. Ta, me MD, cook for a woman. Am I mad? Ah, Oga, before my hand, though.
MD, now listen. I can see that the height of your stupidity and your insolence has gotten to its maximum. MD, even if you are the only advisor in this world, I, Caleb, would prefer to live without advice than listening to the jargon that always proceeds from that loose drinking mouth of yours.
Ah, Oga, take it easy now. It's just an advice. Don't take it personally, okay?
In fact, your days here are numbered. Enough of your madness.
Smoker's brush for a child.
I thought because that was the only brush left in their bookshop last night. He should manage it like that.
Manage what? Come on, Andy. This brush is too big for Jumbo. You will have to buy him another brush, you.
For what? Why will I buy him another one? Who told you the brush is too big for him?
Andy, this is Smoker's brush. It will be too big and harsh for Jumbo's mouth. Jumbo is still a child, though.
He will use it like that. Doctor, don't disturb me, please. Besides, that your Jumbo is not even a child. He will use the big and harsh brush to brush his mouth because the words that comes out from that mouth is always big and harsh.
Empty! What are you saying?
You heard me. End of discussion.
You said you had an appointment with your doctor. Hope all is well.
Had ailment crisis some days ago, so I decided to see my doctor.
Okay, and what ailment is that? The ulcer?
Yep, I've been feeling some stomach discomfort these days.
So what did your doctor say?
The usual, eat well, and he gave me some medicines to take.
Fred, you skip meals a lot, and which is not good for your health condition.
Caleb, you know how occupied we used to be due to this job. I hardly even have time to cook, and you know I don't like eating outside.
And this whole issue boils down to the reason why you should get married.
Caleb, I will. Haven't found anyone yet.
Fred, honestly, you need to become more serious with the search. You need a wife as soon as possible.
Here is the water, sir.
Oh, thanks.
Any other thing else?
For now, no. If I still need something else, I would let you know.
It's all right, sir. Sir, you have been so busy these days. Seems you have much doing. How can I be of help to you, sir?
Thanks, Sandra. Don't worry. It's just the audition coming up next week. I'm just tidying, compiling and inspecting some things.
Okay, I thought as much. Sir, I must confess you are so hardworking, diligent, creative, smart, productive, and above all, a noble gentleman. It's been nice work with you, sir.
What can I say? I'm honored. Thanks for the compliments. It has been nice working with you.
Oh, thank you, sir.
I don't know what I was thinking that made me forget my phone in the office. I have never made such a mistake before. Oh, I know my wife must have called me countless times.
Can you imagine? I've been calling my husband since morning. A young lady kept picking his call, telling me that my husband forgot his phone and went for a meeting.
Are you serious?
My dear, I don't know what Caleb was thinking that made him forget his phone.
Hold on, Linda. Don't tell me that you believe what that young lady told you. How can your husband forget his phone and a young lady has been picking his call since morning? Oh, come on, sis. I think you should start investigating who the mystery woman is.